Good morning, children, and welcome to all of you in online classes. Dear students, we are discussing the chapter 2 of Hornbill book, and the name of chapter is We Are Not Afraid to Die If We Can Be All Together. Dear students, this particular chapter has been written by Gordon Cook and Ellen East. They were the renowned and famous writers of English literature. We are discussing in this lesson that the narrator of the lesson, who is a 37-year-old businessman and who dreamed with his wife to complete a long sea journey all around the world and to see different places of the world through that voyage, through that sea journey, as Captain James Cook had done before 200 years ago. Dear students, we discussed in previous videos that how he prepared his boat, how it took time to complete many things which were required in their journey, how they were trained under the guidance of expert in powerful waves. And we have also discussed that they started their journey in 1976 in month of July with two other crew members. Apart from narrator's family, they were Mr. Larry Wiesel and Mr. Segler. We discussed in the previous part, in the previous videos, that the narrator was very happy with his team members in his first part of journey, and they completed 1,05,000 kilometer distance, and we discussed, dear students, that in this journey they enjoyed a lot. They were moving towards their destination, and we also discussed that when they reached there in the sea, that was 3,500 kilometer away from Cape Town, and their ship was caught in dangerous situation, or the sea waves started raising high. They were surrounded by the heavy clouds. But in that adverse situation, narrator celebrated Christmas. Or in that adverse situation, narrator celebrated New Year. Or he was expecting that the weather will be fine. But I want to tell you, dear students, as I have explained in the previous video, that weather became worst than before, or the sea waves started raising as high as the mast of their ship Babe Walker. Or in that dangerous situation, it was difficult for the narrator and his team members to survive. We discussed that how he was smashed with wheels, how he was thrown into the sea, how he was again reached to his boat babe walker, or this time how his mouth was filled with blood and with broken teeth, how his left rib was broken. The narrator was badly injured. But in that injured situation, he showed patience or he supported his all team members. Even his daughter Suzanne was badly injured. There was a severe head injury. But she also showed patience. She also showed courage. That he advised his wife to stand at wheel and to control the boat. His two crewmen, Mr. Larry Wiesel and Mr. Segler, they were continuously working at pump to evacuate the water which was collected on the boat. This process was going on. But I have told you in the previous video that the deck of the ship was broken by that powerful waves, or it was difficult for the narrator to manage and to repair. But with hammer, with screws, with canvas, he tried to repair. One side he was repairing, or another side the crew members were busy at pump to take out the water from the boat to face that dangerous situation. This was going on. Up to this we discussed in the previous video. Dear students, here the narrator wants to tell ki apart from these situations, apart from these things, one serious and severe situation faced by the narrator was ki that their pumps stopped working. The pump on which the two crewmen were working, that pump stopped working. What was the reason behind it? I am just reading. More problems arose when our hand pumps started to block. Or what was the reason of that problem? Block up with the debris floating around the cabin and electric pump short circuited. So, dear students, the reason of that problem in pump, that the debris means that rubbish which was all around the boat, that blocked the particular pump. Not only it blocked, but due to entering that rubbish in the pump, it was short circuited also. So it was difficult for the narrator and his team member to survive. Anyhow, he searched for another pump. The water level rose threateningly, dangerously. The water level on the boat was rising dangerously. Here is given, a narrator searched another pump. Or here is given, ki luckily here is given, ki I found our two spare hand pumps. Or where they had been wrenched overboard. They were pulled violently along with the first cell or dignities and main anchor. At that time, narrator remember ki there was another electric pump. Or where? In chart room floor. When this situation was going on, when the narrator's hand pumps stopped working, or he searched many places, could not find. At that time he remembered that one spare hand pump was there, electric hand pump. I remembered we had another electric pump under the chart room floor. or the writer connected that pump to outpipe, to an outpipe, or he was very happy and thankful that it was working, that particular hand pump was working, or in this way, dear students, he tried to face that dangerous situation. Or whole night they were working, whole night they were facing the same situation. They were continuously working on pump, or steering that boat and working the radio. But unfortunately, dear students, they were not getting any replies, as they were in remote area. Writer, narrator is telling ki as they were not getting proper signal, it was not surprising, because in such remote areas, such things can be possible. Understood? But they were moving ahead. They were moving forward in that and dangerous situation, in that and adverse situation. Continuously, the writer is badly injured. His daughter is badly injured. Ship is almost damaged. Two pumps stopped working. Another electric pump was arranged that was kept in chart room. Or that was working, or with that they were moving forward, or trying to take out the water from the boat. On 3rd January, dear students, what happened? Ki writer found ki after 15 hours their struggle, the bay walker was not in position to reach Australia. Their boat, their ship was not able to reach Australia in that adverse situation. Narrator started calculating. Narrator checked his charts and calculated that there were two islands. As it was not possible to reach Australia, so in that situation, the narrator decided to calculate and to search the nearest place. Or he found there were two islands. Or they were only some hundred kilometers away from that place. Or in that, dear students, one island that was Amsterdam. Islands Amsterdam was a French scientific base, or there was only hope to reach these pinpricks, these small areas, instead of reaching to Australia. The narrator first decided to suppose reach to the safer place instead of completing his journey. Or when he calculated, he found that there were two islands, or that was the nearest one was Amsterdam, islands Amsterdam, or only the and one more, only these pinpricks in the vast ocean were for them. Only these two small areas were for the narrator and his family members were to reach safely. After that, they continued, and on 4th January, dear students, after 36 hours of their struggle, they were continuously pumping. They were continuously working at the pump. But one good news was there, ki that water level was under the control. A few centimeters only the water was in the boat. And finally, dear students, the narrator was happy, but still the problem was not over. Here is given, Mary found and when the situation became under control, his wife Mary found some corned beef eating item, because from last 36 hours they have not eaten anything. So they were completely hungry. So his wife brought what? That corned beef and cracker biscuits. So two eating items were brought by his wife or they ate. It was their first meal in almost 2 days. After, matlab, for last 36 hours, they had eaten nothing, dear students. Our writer finally, our respite was short-lived. The writer here is telling that their relief was only for some time. At 4 p.m. on 4th January, the weather became again dangerous. Are black clouds began building up behind us. Or in that situation, dear students, the wind was back at 40 knots. The unit of speed. Wind again started with the speed of 40 knots. KNOTS. Or it was getting higher and higher. On 15th January, dear students, again the situation became desperate. 4th January, the situation was under control, but at the 4 p.m., again the dark clouds started gathering. Again the problem came. Again on 5th January, the situation was desperate. Writer went to the children. Writer went to comfort his children, to comfort his son and daughter. Or finally he found, or he wanted to support them. But his son Jonathan gave one amazing, surprising, a very inspiring statement, dear students. Firstly, he asked, Daddy, are we going to die? But at the same time, he said to the writer, Daddy, we should continue. We are not afraid to die. This statement was stated by, said by son Jonathan, 6 years old. Or what he said, ki we are not afraid of dying if we can be all together. All means if his wife Mary, if his son Jonathan, if his daughter Suzanne and other two crew members, if they are together, so they should not afraid to die. Reason, if we can be all together, because unity gives us strength, unity increases our courage. Or after that, dear students, they started working and they managed different things. The narrator to protect the weakened starboard side, the writer decided to do many things. For that, he managed a heavy nylon rope and 22 liter plastic barrels paraffin, or with that he tried to repair and to manage that situation. And finally, dear students, in the evening, what happened? Or while I was thinking, his daughter Sue came and joined him. A writer found the left side of her head was now very swollen. That portion where she was injured, that head injury, or black, here is given, blackened eyes. Writer saw this and narrowed to slits. Or due to that, It was she was not able to open her eyes properly, but she gave one card to the narrator. One card to the narrator. In that, she made what? She drawn the caricatures of Mary and the author, the narrator of the lesson. The girl in that adverse situation made one card for his father, for her father. Or in that, two caricatures were made. One of narrator's narrator and another of his wife Mary by his daughter Suzanne. Or in that here is given, she has written message that she loved both. She loved her father also, or she loved her mother also. Or so this card is to say thank you for what? And let's hope for the best. Or somehow they managed the situation, and writer checked and rechecked his calculation, or he found that he had lost the main compass, or by other devices he calculated, or he found, dear students, about 2 p.m. he went to the deck, and he found that Larry moved the ship at 185 degree. After calculation, the writer advised the Larry to move the ship at 185 degree to reach to the safer place. What happened, dear students? Or one doubt was there, ki whether they will reach to the safer place or not. If they were lucky, they will reach to the safer place. If we were lucky, I told him with a conviction, with a strong opinion, I did not feel he had expected to see the island about 5 p.m. With heavy heart, dear students, the writer bent below and climbed up the bunk amazingly, and then he woke up at 6 p.m. It was getting dark. Or after that, dear students, his son Jonathan came, or he had given good news to him. Where is written? At the moment his son appeared, "Can I have a hug?" Son asked his father whether can he hug his father, can he embrace his father. So father asked for what reason he was going to embrace him, hug him. The son replied, "Papa, father, daddy, we reached to the safe place. We reached to Amsterdam. I live in Amsterdam." No doubt, nobody can. No, not today, John. I am afraid. "You must be," said Sue, the matter of fact wise. Or they replied, son replied that they finally reached to that island. And after that, dear students, they were welcomed by all, here is given 28 inhabitants present there at Amsterdam Islands. Writer here is given was very much emotional to think the struggle of each member in that adverse situation. Ki how Larry and Wiesel, they were working continuously, and they were in that adverse situation. How his daughter Mary stayed, how his wife Mary stayed at the wheel for all those crucial hours, how she managed, how his son behaved courageously, how his daughter, who was badly injured, how she had shown courage. Writer was thinking all that. Most of all, I thought the 7-year-old girl who did not want to worry, who did not want to create any tension for the writer about the head injury. Or after that, 6 operations were done to remove a recurring blood and blood clotting between skin and skull of his daughter. 6 operations were required. 6 operations were made. Or small loss to remove that blood clotting. To means in that tragic situation, or how his son Jonathan supported him. How we are not afraid to die if we can be all together. Anyhow, the narrator, 37-year-old businessman, he succeeded to reach that place, Isle Amsterdam. But the journey was really difficult. You will read, dear students, the whole lesson. If you have any problem, you may ask. Thank you, dear students.